motor mount, you can see that it fits in there perfect. Check the thrust angle. That looks really good. Hope you can see that. Some guys will even put a little right thrust in there. I don't put the right thrust on this one. I don't think you need it. If you want to, that's fine. A lot of airplanes, to really fly good, they need down thrust and a little bit of right thrust. It's no fun when a pretty day to fly comes along and you finally get a chance to get out and take advantage of it. And something happens and all of a sudden you don't have an airplane to fly. This is the kind of stuff that doesn't happen. So now here's the Joker. And we'll get an idea how he's going up. Again, taking this, matching it up. I can see that I've got a gap right here because of the thickness of my trap pieces. That's okay, you'll see. That's where the sandpaper comes in. Anyway, this is where we're basically at right now. Okay guys, you can see here that I finished up my center keel, as I call it, the root rib, the motor mount stick is sandwiched in there, and I'm getting ready to glue it to the first side, and I don't know if you can see it real good, but I had to make a sand to make kind of a little step where this front half is doubled up to capture that motor mount stick so that it matches up real good with my glue joint. You don't want any big gaps in there, so you can see that I got that looking good. I'm getting ready to put the hot glue on there. Okay, for the remainder of this video, I want to talk about the motor. We did a good job of getting our motor mount tube installed into the quarter inch balsa before we glued the two wing halves to each side of it. Here you can see how that works on Superman. Superman probably has over 1,000 flights on him now, and the motor mount is as strong as it was from the time he got built. Until we came up with that motor mount, we used to regularly have problems like the Flash here. Without the strength of that motor mount and this wood keel, then just over a normal course of landing, belly landing, the front of the aircraft gets spongier and spongier. I think Ray, Green Lantern term, came up with the term accordion, and that's what eventually would happen, and then the nose would break off, and then there you go. So that doesn't happen anymore. So the Joker here is starting to take shape. Go ahead and stick the vertical keel in there. And the glue will be there. And we're going to go ahead and test fit our motor. I like to hand wind my motors, and it's real easy to do. That'll be something for a future topic. So now you can see there, the motor is the Turnigy 2730 with a EMP 6x5 prop. It's mounted up in the plane. All this was done today. It's taken about 2 hours to get this point, just working on a little bit at a time. And then slide our vertical fin in. So there we go. We got us a new wing, fin, motor, glued together. The next thing we're going to be doing is cutting our ailerons and then talking about the different ways that you can decorate it, whether Superman here is painted, and the Flash here is a combination of paint. The red is paint, but the lightning bolts, the Flash, that's just printed on an inkjet printer, and then use a little glue stick to put that on before you start applying the tape. So after we get it decorated, I hope you like what you've seen so far. Ray and I are going to be cutting some more cores later this week. Already I've had reply emails, and we got about 6 people wanting cores. That's not a problem at all. As you can see, we got lots and lots of foam, and Ray's got another big block coming. Get our design. Then the last thing we'll be doing is taping the whole aircraft to get the strength that we were looking for. And then we'll, the video after that, we'll talk about servo, rate receiver, speed control, wiring up the motor, making a hatch for the battery, and getting ready for the first test flight.